Hey guys, it's Sarah, and I am here to do my February book haul. And this one is shorter. I only have 10 books to show you guys, and I only bought 4 of them. The rest I actually got from publishers. So I'm very, very excited. I was sent quite a few books recently, and which is super awesome. I'm incredibly grateful for that. So let's go ahead and get into it. All right, this first one is actually a sweet gift that I got from one of my subscribers. Thank you very much. We've already talked and I thank you for this. I'm so excited about it. But she very kindly sent me a Karen Slaughter. This is a short story, so this is very, very short. This is called Last Breath. I have no idea what it's about. I don't care. It's Karen Slaughter. I'm going to read it. It's going to go right here next to my Karen Slaughter books. And then I may save this for a readathon at some point because it's, you know, very short and it's Karen Slaughter. So I can probably easily read this in one sitting. No problem. But I'm very excited about it. Karen Slaughter has quite a few like novellas and short stories and stuff that are getting published in these little mini editions. So I'm very excited to have this one. So thank you. This next one was sent to me from William Morrow, and I was shocked. I was not expecting to get this at all. And it's been on my radar to pick up. It's by an author I haven't read yet, but I really want to. And I have a feeling her books are going to be something I really enjoy. And then a finished copy of this showed up at my door and I was like, what? So I got The Huntress by Kate Quinn. I was completely shocked. Kate Quinn also wrote The Alice Network, and that was a big one that came out. I don't know, remember if it was last year or the year before, but that's a big one that a lot of people really seem to like, and I wanted to read that one. I haven't read it yet, but I got this one, and I was shocked. And then they ended up emailing me, you know, following up to make sure I got it, and then we kind of set a timeline for when I'm going to do a review. So that's going to be coming up very soon, but I'm so excited. This is historical fiction. I can't wait to read it, and I will have a review for this up very soon. And this comes out on February 26th. This next one was sent to me from Dutton, and they contacted me and asked me if I'd be interested in reading this one. And I said yes. And that is The Afterword by E.K. Johnston. I don't know if this is supposed to be the start of a series or not, but I do know it's like a young adult female fighting fantasy type of book. This did just come out. It came out February 19th, so it is available now. But I'm excited to read this. I'm not 100% sure what the premise is. I'm going to kind of go into a little bit blind, but I have not read anything by E.K. Johnston yet. I've seen a lot of her books going around and a lot of people reading them. So I jumped on the chance to do a review for one of them. This next one I was completely shocked to get. This is actually one that I requested like months ago. I even almost forgot that I requested it. And it's on my most anticipated list for the first part of the year. And when the ARC showed up, I was completely floored and just surprised that I got it. So this was sent to me from Atria. And that is House on Fire by Bonnie Kistler. And this comes out on March 12th. So I'm definitely going to be planning to read this in the month of March. I am just so excited. This is going to be kind of a domestic family drama type. I don't know if it's going to have a thriller aspect to it or not, or if it's just going to be a family drama, but I'm very, very excited to read it. I'm hearing really good things about it from people who have been reading it already. And I'm definitely going to be reading this very soon. I was so shocked when it showed up. This next one was also sent to me from William Morrow. It's one that came unsolicited. So this is called Hunting Laroe. And this is actually a nonfiction book. This is by Elaine Shannon. And there's a foreword by Michael Mann, who is a filmmaker. He makes a lot of like thriller movies and fast paced kind of action stuff. And this is called The Inside Story of the DEA Takedown of a Criminal Genius and His Empire. So it actually follows a person named Laroe. He was a real person. And I think the FBI took him down, and he kind of like told them everything and walked them through everything. And I think this is supposed to chronicle that. I believe this is also being made into either a film or a documentary or something like that. That's kind of what I'm getting from the press that they sent along with it. So I may read it. I don't know. We'll have to see. I've never heard of this person or anything like that. But maybe, you know, when I'm in the mood for a good, probably action-packed nonfiction, maybe I will give this one a read. This next one was also sent to me by Atria, and this came unsolicited. I'd never heard of this book, but it's kind of adorable. So this is called In Miniature, and this is by Simon Garfield. And this is called How Small Things Illuminate the World. So it's like maybe little things or little inventions that make a big impact on us. And look, it's miniature. It's a miniature book too, which I thought is just super adorable. So this is a nonfiction book, and I will tell you a couple of things that are highlighted in here. So we have miniature villages and cities, portrait of a marriage and how miniature painting laid it bare, theater of dreams, the domestic ideal, big model railway in the world. So just kind of like, you know, little things that are making a big impact is what I'm understanding from this. So it was super cute. And this comes out March 12th. This next one was sent to me from St. Martin's Press, and that is Saving Megan. And this is by DJ Palmer. This is definitely a psychological thriller. I think it's supposed to be something that follows a girl, and she's kind of questioning whether or not the things around her that are happening are real. Maybe she thinks they're in their head, or she's getting signs that they're in her head, or, you know, whatever the case may be. But this comes out on April 9th. So I do plan to read this around the release date as well. And this one came with a really cool bookmark, and it's like a holograph type thing. It's all real, or it's all in your, or this is in your head, I think is what, it, yeah, it's all in your head. And then it's all real. And I'm only getting the real part because my lights are just like, it's all real, apparently. But the other part says it's all in your head, depending on how you hold it up. So that was pretty cool. I really like that bookmark a lot. So yeah, I'm very excited about this one. Okay, so those are the books that were sent to me. I'm incredibly blessed. Thank you so much to all the publishers for sending those books my way. I'm really excited about them. And I was very good, and I only got, actually, I got four books, but one of them is for my daughter as well. So I'll go into that one at the end. But the first one that I got is from Book Outlet. It's one that has been on my wish list for a couple of months now. I heard Elena from Elena Reads Books talk about this, and she really enjoyed it. And I put it on my wish list, and then it showed up on Book Outlet, and it was pretty cheap, and they only had a couple copies left. So I went ahead and grabbed it. But that is Death's Acre. And this is by Dr. Bill Blass and John Jefferson. And it's inside the legendary forensic lab, the Body Farm, where the dead do tell tales. So that's a mouthful there, but this follows an actual lab called the Body Farm, and it's where they take bodies, I believe, that have been donated in order to kind of study the decomposition. And I think they base a lot of crime results, you know, like forensics people are able to get their results because of the studies that were done on these bodies. And it's a real place. So, I'm mildly interested in this. It's just like kind of morbidly interested in it. And yeah, so I think it'll be a very interesting read. The next one that I picked up, I found at a used bookstore. And okay, so I kind of broke one of my rules. I said I was not going to buy any sequels until I have read at least the first in the series, and I know that I'm going to read it, and I know that I want to read it, and blah, blah, blah. And I've kind of already broken that because I went ahead and picked up kind of a sequel. And yeah, so I got Batman by Marie Lu. This is the second book in the DC Icons series. And I hesitate to call it a sequel because they're more companion books, but these are basically superhero books. And I think there's going to be four of them total. And they're written by different YA authors. So this one's written by Marie Lu. I also have Wonder Woman that was written by Leigh Bardugo. And then Catwoman is also out, which is written by Sarah J. Maas. And then there is Superman coming out. And I do not remember who writes that one. It's a male author, though. I just can't remember his name off the top of my head. But I found this at a used bookstore, and it was only $9, and I had some store credit, so I even got it for cheaper than that. So I got it. All right, this next one is going to make some of you extremely happy. Extremely happy. Oh, I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I got Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin. I found this at the same used bookstore. It was $9. I had a credit, so I got it for a little bit cheaper as well. It is a huge floppy paperback. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and pick that up. And I do like the cover. This is a movie or TV show tie-in cover with all people. So yeah, I went ahead and picked it up. And I do plan to read this because it is part of the Great American Reads, and I want to read everything on that list. Now, I consider doing the audiobook for this one because it is a really big, huge, high fantasy, and I'm terrified of it. But I also know that I do not do well with fantasy books on audio. I tend to miss things. I tend to miss important things. I tend to miss little details that make a big difference in the story for me. So listening to fantasy books on audio does not work very well. And I don't think this one will work very well either. So I'm going to read it physically. And I bought it physically. So I have it. I am not making any promises that this is going to happen this year, guys. So I don't want you guys in the comments telling me to read it immediately. I do not think that that's going to happen. But I do own it now. I got it while it was cheap. I have it in my possession. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. And the last one that I got, I also got at Book Outlet, and I grabbed it from there because it's a book that I'm going to be reading for my school class, my materials for children class. And when I talked about what I was going to be reading for that, my daughter, I talked about reading this one and she said, I want to read that too, Mom. And I was like, okay, then I'm going to buy it. So I'm going to read it. And then she wants to read it as well. So when I'm done reading it, I'll just give it to her. But that is The War That Saved My Life by Kimberly Brubaker Bradley. I cannot say her name like without really, really thinking about it. It's just my letters get all mixed up. But this is a historical fiction book, and it follows a young girl during, I believe, World War II time frame, and she has a physical disability. She has a cleft foot, I believe, or a clubbed foot. Clubbed, that's the right word. Clubbed foot, where her foot is turned inward. And so I think it's kind of following her and how all that is affecting her life. And this was a Newbery Honor book as well. So it's going to be great to read for my class. So, and we are doing a discussion post as well on this for a historical fiction book. So I'm going to make sure I read this in time to do my discussion post. And then it's going to count towards my overall big reading project at the end of the semester as well. So I do plan to read this very early in March, and I'm excited about it. I have heard just really amazing things about this book in general. So I'm excited to be adding it to my collection. Okay, guys, I'm jumping in because I literally just got this book in the mail and I recorded my video today. And of course, like 6 hours later, it shows up. I'm like, okay, great. I got this as well, Before She Knew Him by Peter Swanson. I actually won this on Goodreads, you guys. I won a Goodreads giveaway for the first time ever. And I've entered probably thousands of them. So yay. Worth the wait. This is one of my most anticipated reads this year. I have read Peter Swanson before and really enjoyed, so I would definitely want to read more from him, and this will be great to read this year. This comes out in March, and so I would maybe try to read it if I can around that time, I hope. I kind of have a lot going on, so we'll see if I can get to it, but definitely this year, because this is going to be on my most anticipated for the year, so I'm excited to read it. Okay, guys, that is it. That's actually 11 books because I completely forgot about The War That Saved My Life. But 11 books, that's probably the least amount of books I've hauled in a while, in a month. Just, I was very good. I was very controlled. Most of those books were sent to me by publishers, which was my goal this month, was to have more books sent to me than I purchased. And I definitely met that goal. So I'm very happy about that. And I'm excited to get to all of these. So let me know your thoughts down below. Let me know what I should get to sooner rather than later. Since a lot of these were sent by publishers, a lot of these will be showing up in review videos soon as well. And I'm excited about them. So, all right, that's going to be it for me. Let me know your thoughts, and I will talk to you guys again soon. Have a great day. Bye.